Today we are going to talk briefly about hepatitis. We start with the question of what is hepatitis? Hepatitis refers to an inflammatory condition of the liver. It is commonly caused by viral infection, but there are other possible causes of hepatitis. This includes autoimmune hepatitis and hepatitis that occur as a secondary result of medications like drugs, toxins, and alcohol. Actually, there are five types of hepatitis. This time around, we talk of viral hepatitis. Viral infection of the liver that are classified as hepatitis include hepatitis A, hepatitis B, hepatitis C, hepatitis D, and E, and hepatitis E. Different virus is responsible for each type of virally transmitted hepatitis. For example, hepatitis A is always an acute short-term disease, while hepatitis B, C, and D are most likely to become ongoing and chronic. When we are talking of chronicity, we are talking of it will become long-standing. Hepatitis E is usually acute, but can be particularly dangerous in pregnant women. Now we'll talk about hepatitis A. Hepatitis A is caused by an infection with hepatitis A virus. This type of hepatitis is most commonly transmitted by consuming food or water contaminated by feces from the person infected with hepatitis A. That is, it is a fecal-oral infection. It is infection you get by ingesting either feces or any food contaminated from waste of somebody that has hepatitis A. The second is hepatitis B. Hepatitis B is transmitted through contact with infectious body fluids, such as blood, vaginal secretion, or semen containing the hepatitis B virus. Injection drug use, having sex with an infected partner, or sharing razors with an infected person increase your risk of getting hepatitis B. Another thing about hepatitis B is that it can be transferred from mother to child in pregnancy also. Now we'll talk about hepatitis C. Hepatitis comes from hepatitis C virus. Hepatitis C is transmitted through direct contact with infected body fluids, typically through injection, drug use, and sexual contact, just like hepatitis B. One very dangerous thing about hepatitis is that it is silent. If you have it, you will not know. Unlike hepatitis B, when you have it, you have yellowness of the eyes. Hepatitis C will just be there quietly. Hepatitis D is also called Delta hepatitis. Hepatitis D is a serious liver disease caused by the hepatitis D virus. Hepatitis D virus is contracted through direct contact with infected blood. Hepatitis D is a rare form of hepatitis that only occurs in conjunction with hepatitis B infection. The hepatitis D virus cannot multiply without the presence of hepatitis B. What it means is that you cannot be infected with hepatitis D alone. There must be undercurrent infection with hepatitis B before you can be infected with hepatitis D. So hepatitis B and D are like husband and wife. Then, the last but not the least viral hepatitis is hepatitis E. Hepatitis E is a waterborne disease caused by hepatitis E virus. Hepatitis E is mainly found in areas with poor sanitation and typically result from ingesting fecal matter that contaminates the water supply. Just like hepatitis A, where it is fecal-oral infection, the same thing with hepatitis E. How is hepatitis treated? Treatment options are determined by which type of hepatitis you have and whether the infection is acute or chronic. When we are saying chronic, we are talking of how long you have been infected. That is the duration. When something is long-standing, it is called chronic. Not that it is because of the seriousness that makes you, I have chronic disease. No. We start with hepatitis A. Hepatitis A usually doesn't require treatment because it is a short-term illness. Bed rest may be recommended if symptoms cause a great deal of discomfort. If you experience vomiting or diarrhea, follow your doctor's order for hydration and nutrition. The hepatitis A vaccine is available to prevent this infection. Most children begin vaccination between ages 12 and 18 months. It is a series of two vaccines. Vaccination for hepatitis A is also available for adults, and it can be combined with the hepatitis B vaccine. Hepatitis B. Acute hepatitis B doesn't require specific treatment. Chronic hepatitis B is treated with antiviral medication. This form of treatment can be costly because it must be continued for several months or years. Treatment for chronic hepatitis B also requires regular medical evaluation and monitoring to determine if the virus is responding to treatment. Hepatitis B can be prevented with vaccination. The Center for CDC, that is Center for Disease Control, recommends hepatitis B vaccination for all newborns. The series of three vaccines is typically completed over the first 6 months of childhood. The vaccine is also recommended for all healthcare and medical personnel. That is, all those that are at risk of getting hepatitis B by the mode of their work, like people that work in the laboratory, like the doctors, like surgeons, they must be vaccinated against hepatitis B to prevent them from getting infected from their patients. Hepatitis C. Antiviral medications are used to treat both acute chronic form of hepatitis C because people who develop chronic hepatitis are typically treated with a combination of antiviral drug therapy. They may also need further testing to determine the best form of treatment. People who develop cirrhosis, that is scarring of the liver, or liver disease as a chronic hepatitis C may be a candidate for liver transplant. Currently, there is no vaccination for hepatitis C. Hepatitis D. No antiviral medication exists for the treatment of hepatitis D at this time. According to a 2013 study, a drug called alpha interferon can be used to treat hepatitis D, but it only shows improvement in about 25 to 30% of people. So that means that it's not a very effective treatment. Hepatitis D can be prevented by getting the vaccination for hepatitis B, as infection with hepatitis B is necessary for hepatitis D to develop. So that means that if you are immunized against hepatitis B, it gives you a protection against hepatitis D infection because hepatitis D needs hepatitis B for it to get to infect anybody. Hepatitis E, currently no specific treatment, no specific medical therapy are available to treat hepatitis because the infection is often acute. It typically resolves on its own. People with this kind of infection are often advised to get adequate rest, drink plenty of fluid, get enough nutrients, and avoid alcohol. However, pregnant women who develop this infection require close monitoring and care. Tips to prevent hepatitis. One, hygiene. They say cleanliness is next to godliness. Practicing good hygiene is one key way to avoid contracting hepatitis A and E. If you are traveling to a developing country, you should avoid local water, ice, raw or undercooked shellfish and oysters, raw fruit and vegetables. Hepatitis B, C, and D, contracted through contaminated blood, can be prevented by not sharing drug needles, not sharing razors, not using somebody else's toothbrush, not touching spilled blood. Hepatitis B and C can only be contracted through sexual intercourse and intimate sexual contact. Practicing safe sex by using condoms and dental dams can help decrease the risk of infection. You can find many options available for purchase online. Vaccine. The use of vaccine is an important key to preventing hepatitis. Vaccinations are available to prevent the development of hepatitis A and B. Experts are currently developing vaccines against hepatitis C. A vaccination for hepatitis E exists in China, but it isn't available in the United States. What are the complications of hepatitis? Chronic hepatitis B or C can often lead to more serious health problems because the virus affects the liver. People with chronic hepatitis B or C are at the risk of 1. Chronic liver disease, 2. Liver cirrhosis, and 3. Liver cancer. When your liver stops functioning normally, liver failure can occur. Complications of liver failure include 1. Bleeding disorder. The reason for this is the clotting factors are produced by the liver. Some of them. So, if the liver is diseased, now ability to produce it is decreased, so the person will be bleeding abnormally. There's a buildup of fluid in your abdomen known as ascites. 3. Increased blood pressure in portal vein can enter your liver known as portal hypertension. 3. It can cause kidney failure. It can cause what you call hepatic encephalopathy, which can evoke fatigue, memory loss, and diminished mental ability due to the buildup of toxins like ammonia that affect brain function. And can cause hepatocellular carcinoma, which is a form of liver cancer or death. People with chronic hepatitis B and C are encouraged to avoid alcohol because it can accelerate liver disease and failure. Certain supplements and medication can also affect liver function. If you have chronic hepatitis B or C, check with your doctor before taking any new medication. Thank you.